Hi everybody, very welcome to Mentour and yet another video podcast. As always, I hope you're doing absolutely fantastic. Today on the podcast, guys, we're going to be talking about altimeters. How do pilots judge how high they are above the airport and what is a flight level? Stay tuned. Right guys, this video is brought to you in cooperation with brilliant.org. Brilliant.org is a website that will help you perfect your mathematical skills and your physics knowledge, something that you might well need when you're applying for a flight school or an airline job. So check them out. And at the end of this video, I'm going to have a small nut for you guys to crack, so stay tuned. Right guys, when we're talking about altimeters and how we as pilots judge altitude, it's important to have a little bit of basic physics knowledge. This is why I keep pressing with you guys that it's so important that you pay attention during your physics lessons, okay? Because an altimeter on board an aircraft, even in a modern aircraft like this, is essentially just measuring the outside pressure, all right? It is just a pressure gauge. So the technology we're using is pretty much the same as the first aviators were using, as the aircraft had back in the 60s and 70s. We're using the same thing. Around the aircraft, you can see them on the side of the aircraft close to the nose section. There are static inlets. Those take out the static pressure outside of the aircraft, and we use that to convert it into altitude. Okay, so the first thing that you need to understand is that when it comes to altimeters, the reason that we're using pressure to measure our altitude is because the atmosphere has a really, really nice feature of having a linear decrease of pressure as you climb. So basically, for every 30 feet that you climb, the pressure is going to drop with approximately 1 hectopascal. Right, that's important to remember. So for each 30 feet you go up, it's going to drop 1 hectopascal. All right. Now, measuring the altitude of the aircraft would be really, really easy if the atmosphere was completely uniform over the globe. But that is not the case. The atmosphere essentially looks like it looks pretty much like, you know, the surface of the Earth, where you have high mountains and deep valleys. In the case of the atmosphere, those mountains and valleys are high pressures or low pressures, which I'm sure you've heard of if you've ever watched the Weather Channel. Okay, but how does that affect us? Well, since our altimeters are essentially pressure gauges, it also means that it doesn't really know where we are to start with. The only thing that the altimeter knows is if the pressure is decreasing or increasing. Now, what we want to know, obviously, is exactly how high we are. So we use something called QNH, which is essentially the local pressure we have at, for example, the airport of departure. Okay, because it is changing all the time, as those valleys and mountains are moving over the globe, you might have a high pressure on the airport one day and a low pressure on the airport another day. We need to know exactly what the reference pressure is all the time. So if you've listened to air traffic control, you've heard them say QNH quite a few times. Basically, every time an aircraft gets cleared to an altitude, they will be getting the local QNH. Every time we're listening to the 80s, we will also get the QNH, because what we do then is we put that value, which might be, say, QNH is 1009 hectopascal. When we get that, we enter that into our altimeter, and when we do that, if we have the correct pressure setting, then the altitude that we read here on our altimeter is going to show us our altitude above sea level. Right, so QNH will give us the pressure setting to know how high we are above sea level with reference to the airport we are at this time. Okay. Now, why that is interesting to know is because the QNH obviously is different between different airports. So, for example, today the QNH here in Girona is 1,015 hectopascals, and I'm just about to start flying. We're going to fly to Baden-Baden in Germany, and the QNH there is going to be much lower. It's going to be 1,002 hectopascals. Okay, so it is really important that we use the correct pressure setting at the airport we're at, because otherwise our altimeters is not going to show us where we are. Okay, if I, for example, sit here, QNH 1,015, and then I wait for a few hours and the pressure drops, well then the altimeter will assume that I have climbed during that time, and it will show me if it's dropped, for example, 3 hectopascals, well then it will show that I'm actually 90 feet higher than what I'm actually am. This is why it's so important that we continuously update the pressure setting when we are either departing from an airport or descending into an airport. Okay, so that then brings us to flight levels. What is a flight level? Well, as you might have understood by now, if the pressure difference differs between different airports, and we have loads of aircraft taking off and landing at those airports, if they are then, let's say you're taking off from one airport and then you're flying towards somewhere else in Europe, for example, well then you are going to meet other aircraft that are flying from other airports where the pressure was different. So unless we continuously update the pressure as we fly along a route, we will not know how much of a difference in altitude we are from other aircraft, because they might be coming from an airport with a completely different QNH. So it's not really practical to be continuously updating the local pressure. And it's not really interesting either, because we're flying so high that knowing how high we are above the terrain is not really interesting anymore, right? What is interesting is being absolutely sure that we have the vertical separation we need from other aircraft. So the way that that has been solved is that we have said that above a specific altitude, the transition altitude, we will all set the same pressure. All aircrafts that are flying higher than that altitude will set the standard pressure, which is called standard pressure, QNH 1013.25 hectopascals. That is the standard pressure. Okay. So whenever you hear an aircraft being cleared to a flight level, if we are, for example, let's say we are 3,000 feet maintaining, then we have been then we've been using the local QNH up until then. Air traffic control tells us climb now flight level 200. Then what I will do is I will set flight level 200 here, confirm it with my first officer, check it, we'll start climbing, and I will then set standard. When I set standard, we are now climbing towards a flight level. All right? So that means that all over the world, when you hear flight level, all of those aircraft are flying on the same pressure setting of 1013 hectopascal to make sure that everyone they meet have at least the vertical separation distance that is needed in order for safe flight. So that is the difference between QNH, which will give you the correct altitude above sea level, and flight level, which will just give you a knowledge of how, you know, how much vertical separation you have from other aircraft. It will not tell you your correct altitude above ground. Right, we do have other means in the cockpit as well of knowing how high we are. For example, we have the radio altimeter, but the radio altimeter only works from 2,500 feet and down. So it's not accurate, it's not even showing above that. The times that we use the radio altimeter is basically when we are doing a Category 2 or Category 3 ILS. And if you're interested in knowing how we fly a Cat 2 or Cat 3 ILS, I have a collection inside of the Mentor Aviation app that you can get, and you can see how I am actually flying one of those approaches, including the go-around. It's a quite good one, so check it out. Right, guys, so now towards the end here, I promised you that I had a question for you, and there's a little bit of a problem for you to solve. So I've been talking a little bit about how we measure altitude and how the pressure is decreasing with increasing altitude. So I was going into brilliant.org the other day and I checked through their gravitational physics course. And in there was a problem where they asked me, how high do you need to climb in order to reach the edge of space? Okay, the edge of space is defined as when the pressure is 0.1% of the pressure at the surface of the Earth. So that's my question for you guys. How high do you need to climb in order for your pressure to be 0.1% of the pressure you are feeling right now? I want you to answer here in the comments, or you can send it in via Facebook or my Mentor Aviation app. And if you want to know the answer to this question, then check out brilliant.org/mentoredge. I'm going to have a link to it here in the description of the video, and it's going to show you both how to calculate this problem and give you a little bit of background knowledge about it. So check that out, guys. And as always, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope that you have subscribed to the channel, and make sure that you highlight the little notification bell. Otherwise, you won't know when I'm doing live streams and when I'm posting new videos, which I'm doing a little bit more regularly now. So have a fantastic day wherever you are. I am going to take this baby flying now. Take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.